doing a bike review. We are reviewing our own bike, the Triumph Speed Triple 1050. Just to give you a background about this bike is a 2015 model. It has been manufactured in May of 2016, and we purchased this bike in January 2017. Since January 2017 till September 2018, in a span of 20 months, we've covered 28,500 kilometers on the bike, and we are doing great. So today's video will feature the 8 things that we like about this bike and the 8 things that we don't like about this bike. Let's talk about the 8 things that we like about this bike. The first and foremost is the power and the pickup. So this bike has got a maximum power of 133 bhp at 6500 rpm, and it generates a torque of 111 newton meter at 7750 rpm. It is a very crisp pickup. You can race the bike from 0 to 100 kilometers in just a span of 3.5 seconds. That's the first thing that we like about this bike. The second thing that we like about this bike are the tubeless tires. You see, these tires are Metzeler Racetech K3 tires, and they are tubeless. We've had one or two instances where we had to, there was a nail sticking into the tire, and we just had to remove the nail and take the bike to a local tire guy and get it sorted out. It's that simple and easy. The third thing that we like is the comfortable pillion seat. So usually I ride pretty frequently with my wife as a pillion, and she finds the bike really comfortable to sit. We've done long touring on this bike without any back problems or any other issues. Even she doesn't face much of a problem sitting as a pillion. The fourth thing that we like about this is the brakes. So this bike comes equipped with Brembo brakes. Again, the braking is very crisp. The bike can actually slow down from 100 to 0 kilometers in a span of 1 or 2 seconds. That quick. Very effective brakes. The fifth thing that we like about this bike is the comfortable riding position. So this bike is basically a naked sportster. However, the seating position on this is very comfortable and upright. It does not actually lean too much forward like you have your super sports bikes that you see, and neither it is fully upright that you get on an adventure bike. This bike has a seating position which has a slight lean to it, which makes it a very comfortable ride. It's a perfect seating position for touring long distances. The next point that we like about this bike, so this bike is very nimble to ride even in the city. The bike is 214 kgs in weight. However, once the bike picks up speed, it goes about 30 to 40 kilometers an hour. You really don't feel the weight, and it's very easy to maneuver through city traffic very comfortably. The next point that we would like to mention here is the sound of the exhaust. Now, a lot of people, once they buy a super bike, they tend to change their exhaust. They prefer having some aero exhausts or some SE Project exhaust. However, you really don't need any exhaust change on this bike. The sound that these two exhausts make are very sweet, especially between the RPMs of 4000 to 6000. A last point that we would like to mention that we love about this bike are the tires again. I'm not talking about the tube being there or not, but the grip that it generates on the road. We usually do not stop riding even in the rains. So the tires are very, very close to the ground, and they grip to the roads very well, even in case of a wet, slippery road. So guys, these are the 8 points that we like about the bike. Let's talk about the things, 8 things rather, that we don't like about this bike. This bike has a 1050cc engine, and the bike heats up. And the bike heats up really fast, especially in city traffic. So if you can get the camera here onto the dash, So there are these bars here which indicate the cooling temperature. There are 8 bars here. You can see the bars are already 6 in number at the moment. However, when you ride the bike in traffic, at least for a continuous 10 to 15 minutes, these bars keep on climbing. So sometimes it goes to 7 bars, sometimes it also touches full 8 bars. Having said that, once you are out of traffic and you get a clear road to maneuver, these bars again go down and the bike starts to lose its heat equally as quick as possible. So it can be a little uncomfortable in traffic, but it's still pretty okay. You never face such problems on the highways at all. The second thing that we don't like about this bike is that it does not have a main stand. You know, if you are riding very regularly, you need to clean and lube your chain on a regular basis. Triumph recommends that you do the cleaning and the lubing at least every 350 to 400 kilometers. So if you need to do that and you don't have a stand, it becomes a little cumbersome. You need to move your bike ahead and backwards again and again to, you know, do this. Had there been a main stand, it would have been a lot easier. Not a big issue as such. The next point that we come to is there is no windscreen on this. So this bike has capacities to go to 150, 160, 180, even 200 kilometers quite comfortably. And at that speed, you definitely need some kind of protection here. You get some aftermarket windscreens available, but I doubt that they are hardly any useful. Having ridden 28,500 kilometers, I have kind of got used to the wind blast hitting me, and I actually don't feel the need for a windscreen anymore. The next point that we'd like to bring up is this bike on the dash does not have a gear indicator. So these days you get all sorts of bikes, even 125cc bikes come with a gear indicator. Hell, the Street Triple comes with a gear indicator. This Speed Triple doesn't have a gear indicator. I'm actually surprised why Triumph didn't put in this simple thing into the bike. The next point that we don't like about this bike is the seat height. The seat height presently is at 165 mm. The seat height is at 825 mm. Yes, 825 mm it is. So I am 5'9 right now. I find it pretty okay, but for shorter riders, it might get a little uncomfortable, especially if you are 5 feet 5 or 5 feet 6 inches tall. I am 5 feet 9 inches tall. I have both my feet on the ground at the 825 mm. For me, it's pretty comfortable, but for shorter riders, it might not be so comfortable. The next point that we'd like to bring up is this bike does not come with a traction control system. It has ABS, but however, no traction control. Becomes a little tricky when you are riding in rains on slippery roads. The next point that we'd like to bring up is it has a slightly heavier clutch. You feel the heaviness of the clutch when you are riding at slow speeds around 20 to 30 kilometers an hour in traffic. But it's pretty okay, manageable. It does not hurt too much. You get used to the heavy clutch. The last point that we don't like about this is that there are no rider modes in the bike. So these days the bikes come with rain mode, sport mode, the adventure bikes come with enduro modes. However, this bike does not have any mode. That's hardly not a very big factor at all. So that was the review about the bike. We mentioned 8 likes, we mentioned 8 dislikes. The 8 likes overpower the 8 dislikes way too much, and we really don't care about the 8 dislikes of the bike. We love this bike thoroughly, and we continue to ride on it despite the 8 dislikes. And we hope that we have many, 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 many more miles to go on this. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you.